Brett Smith had a fantastic year last year. How does he take that next step from really good to elite?
Well, I think he's taken the steps to try to do that. He's done a lot in his preparation throughout the entire offseason to make himself bigger, stronger, faster, become a student of the game, just spent some time with the man. He passed an academy, also went down to California, worked out with Drew Brees down there and then Garcia. And so, he's learned this summer from some of the best. He's worked extremely hard with us and with his teammates to do everything he possibly do to make sure that he makes the same progress that he's made each of his years he's been with us.
Running the football, I know, is a top priority in getting back to some efficient ground game. Who might be the guys that you look to, and how do you get that going this season?
Well, it's going to be done by a committee this year. We've got four or five running backs that each do a little bit different things, but all are strong at what they do. And we'll roll those guys through, see where we're at in training camp, who has the hot hand, those type of things. But at this point in time, it looks like it's going to pretty much be done by committee.
What have you seen out of your receivers, whether it be in spring ball, or heard about things in workouts that they are who exactly Brett was alluding to?
Well, we've got some guys with playmaking ability, some returners that played last year, Robert Huron, Jalen Claiborne, obviously Dominic Rufram. We've got some guys that we redshirted, got some good young players coming up, some other guys that have had playing time and experience. So we'll be as deep as we've been at receiver. We'll have great competition there, and I would imagine there'll be somewhere 8 to 10 players that are going to be capable of competing for playing time at the receiver position.
Stick with a kind of, if you had to paint it with a broad stroke, a pass set up the run sort of issue, or would you like to see more run set up the pass?
I'd like to be balanced and make it difficult to defend both and not be able to say they're one-dimensional, and that's what we're trying to get to, is just more balance in our attack. And obviously we feel good about our ability to throw the football, but I think you got to be able to run the football also to be successful.
Your secondary, you lose Ruff, which I know is a huge loss from the way he thought about the game of football, played the game of football. Is Quest a guy that can step in there and be that guy?
I think so. Mark Weston's played a lot for us over the last 3 years, and it was a natural progression to move him from corner. He's a big corner. He can play the corner position, but we can put him back there. He can communicate. He knows where guys need to align. He knows the calls, the structure, the scheme that we're running. I think it's going to provide a lot of athleticism on the back end with him and Darren White back there.
Opening up at Nebraska, that's something special, I know, for the kids to be able to go to a place like that, test yourself against a program like that. That's something I know you probably as a coach look forward to as well.
Well, we've played a lot of top-ranked teams since I've been there. This is going to be another great opportunity to play in just a phenomenal venue. I've had an opportunity to coach it in Lincoln a couple times against the Huskers, and so it's exciting for our kids, exciting for our program, and it's exciting because it's a great stadium, but it's going to be a top 10, 15 football team, and so it'll give us an idea where we're at as a football program, certainly on that Saturday evening.